I'll just quickly go through what we have learned earlier. So last time we were talking about columns, floor, ceilings. So let us start today's session. Today we are going to learn how you can make the roof. How will you make the flat roof? How will you make the slope roof? Okay, then we will learn how to create staircase. And depending upon the timing, we will learn how to create railing, ramp, etc. So let's go to roof command from architecture. Build command, build panel roof. So roof can be constructed by two ways. One is with footprint and the other is by extrusion. So let us start with the roof by footprint. So when you want to make the roof, better to go to always, you go to your level two. Go to your level two. And you are ready to do your roofing here. So first, when you click the roof, okay, architecture, build panel, roof, roof by footprint. So when you click the roof by footprint, you can see the option menu which is added here. Here the first box shows define slope. So if you want to construct flat roof, then you have to remove the stick mark. Okay, and this is overhang. Overhang means how much roof you want to project from your wall. That is overhang you have to type. And forget about this now. So let us make first the flat roof. So I will remove the tick mark from here. And you be sure that you are in the level two, because the level two is your roof, there where you are going to do the roof. Okay. Now you are in the sketch mode. Automatically you are in the sketch mode now. So you cannot go out unless you tick or cancel this. So we have to do the boundary line for the roof now. So we are going to have the flat roof. So I will click this pick walls. You see here pick walls. I will click that and go to one of the walls and press the tab so that it select all the walls which is not selected. Forget about that, we can do later. Click. So you created the wall there, and here we have to draw manually this. We'll draw a line from here. And one thing, we have not given the offset here, overhang. So let us give some overhang. Again, I will go to architecture. You're already in the architecture. You're already in the sketch mode. Just cancel it and come back again. Architecture, roof by footprint. I will remove the tick mark because I'm going to make the flat roof now. I want to project the roof from the wall about 500 mm, 50 centimeter. Now I'll draw the boundary wall, boundary line. So pick walls I'm going to use. So I'll go to one of the walls and I'll press the tab. Sometimes it doesn't work, some problem will be there. So in that case, you click one by one wall. Okay, so we have done the wall. When you want to do the roofing, there shouldn't be a cross line like this. So we have to trim corner. This one, and see that it is closed one. Okay, so now you have a closed one. Now, lines must be close. See, there is some gap there somewhere here. We have some wall here which is a cut piece. That is why this problem is coming. Yesterday when we were teaching, there were this wall was cut. That is why this problem is coming. Okay, so we'll do it again now. Architecture, roof by footprint. Go here. Overhang 1000. Oh, sorry, 500. Remove the tick mark because you want to make the flat. Pick the walls. Go here and see that dotted is coming outside, not like this. Then it will be created inside. You have to be like this. Okay, when I click the tab, I get click. And this portion, click. This portion, here are three walls here. Cut piece, see? Okay, so that problem is there. So what we'll do, we'll make, click this wall. We'll draw the line from here to here. Okay. Now we have to trim this piece, corner. So now you can see there is a closed one. And say okay. So it created a flat roof here. You can see from 3D, flat roof has been created. Okay, we'll go back to level 2. Now I want to create a parapet for this. Okay, so for I will create one level for parapet. I'll go to south. We have only two, one is zero level, one level, level 3 there. We want to create one parapet level, so that will be easier. So architecture, confined level. So level can be created two ways. One is with clicking, and these are the ways with pick lines. So I will select the pick line and give the height. We want parapet about 800. Sorry, not here. Here. Level 800. Select the second one. Click. Okay, so you got a level 4, which I will rename to level 4 dash parapet. So it will be easy to understand. Okay, I'll go back to level 2 where this my roof is there. Okay. So now I want to construct a parapet wall here from level 2 to, level 2 is my roof, from there to 800 height. So I will create a new wall, edit type. Better to create one duplicate wall here. I will say parapet, wall. Okay, so I'm in the parapet wall, which I want from level 2 to level parapet level. So I will go again architecture wall and see that here parapet wall, and from level 2, which is my roof level, to level parapet. This is parapet level. So it automatically take the 800. Okay, so I'm going to draw parapet wall from level 2, which is my roof, to parapet level. Let wall. Go to level 2, wall, parapet wall, and here from here you see when I was teaching you the wall, I explained you, you can create wall using pick line. Pick line. So we are in the architectural wall, parapet wall. This is your draw panel. From here I will take the pick lines and show the line here. Click. So it created a wall, parapet wall from level 2 to parapet level, which is 800. You can use the tab also. Go to one of this line, tab, click. So sometime, because there is a portion here, because already constructed here, when you are doing it, start itself you do. Click. So all the walls created. Modify. You can see, go to 3D. You can see that there is a parapet wall. You already constructed parapet wall. You can see this from your elevation. You can see the parapet wall. Okay. This is how you do the flat roof and parapet wall. So let me delete this. I will delete the roof also. This is roof. Create a roof, deleted. Okay. Now we are going to make the slope roof. I hope you got the idea how to make the flat roof. So I will go to level 2, where is the roof has to be made. Architecture roof by footprint. Okay, now I will click the definition slope. Earlier I removed that tick mark. That is why you got the flat. Now you want slope roof. So click the define slope and click the overhang. Okay, now boundary line, and again I will use the pick walls. So go to one of the line, press tab, click. So this portion you have to click again. And here you have to probably, as I told you, there is a some walls here, wall was cut there, that is why this problem was coming. Okay, now corner trim. Corner trim, trim. Okay, so we are finished. See that it is a closed. So still there is a problem here. This gap is giving problem. So what we will do is we'll delete this line. This is coming, as I told you, because this wall is not a single wall. That is why. Delete. Delete. I will draw a line, single line from here to here. Okay. So the roof has been created. You can see that roof has been created. You can orbit and see it. If you, then you can switch off this. Anytime you lose the view, you can just click here, home button. Okay. So you did a slope here. Now I can adjust the gable roof. Let us make it convert to gable roof. You select this, edit footprint, go to level 2. I don't want slope from here to here and from here to here. I need slope like this, slope like this. So I will click this and I can remove tick mark from here, define slope, remove the tick mark from there or define roof slope. So that slope has been removed. Here also I don't want slope like this. So I select that line, remove the define. Okay. So you have gable roof now. And you can see that the wall has not extended to there. The walls is not extended to there. So we have to extend this wall. And the other side also, if you see the orbit, you can see other side also. There is also, this is not extended. Okay, so what we'll do is, we select one wall, make tab and press. So we selected all the walls. Tab, click, and you can see here attach base top. Click that and select the roof. So all the walls extended. Here these are small pieces, so we did not select. So we'll do it separately. So you got extended all the walls. This is how you do the slope roof. Anytime you can change the angle. You can select this. You can change the slope from 30 degree to 40 degree if you want 45 degree. Apply. You can change the slope anytime you want. And suppose you want to change this to glass roof. Maybe sometime you want to do something, then you can use, you select the roof and in the roof you go down. You can see that there is sloped glazing. You can convert this slope into glazed. So click this. And you can see that it is completely glazed now. It is just like our curtain wall. You can put the walls and other things here. I just want to show you, don't get confused. Okay. I think that I will explain you when in the college here, you may get confused. Okay, so I will undo this. So the roof can be converted into glass using, select the roof. And from here, you can connect it to the sloped glazing. And every face will be a curtain wall where you can put the grids. Okay, sometimes some portion you want to show a glass with a pattern and other thing, then that can be used. So these are this is how you do the roof, slope roof. Roof with footprint. Anyone is having it? Now let us, I want to make roof by extrusion. Roof by extrusion. Okay. So for example, why do you want the roof by extrusion? Suppose you want to have a small sunshade, something like that here, projected. Okay, or you want to have something, these two windows connected, a small sunshade, a designed sunshade you want. So there you can use the roof by extrusion. So let's see how to do that. Roof by extrusion. So you have to select a plane where you are going to draw that section. So we have to select the this plane. This wall is where we are going to draw that. So click and select this wall. This one. Okay, click. Okay, level 3, that don't worry about that. Okay, so that means you can, okay, now you are ready to draw it. So we'll go to that particular plane, this plane. Okay, we'll go to, so it was east. West, south. Yeah, it was in south only. So this is the plane we selected. Even we can repeat that, no problem. Now we are ready to draw the section of the cross section. So I go to that particular elevation where you want to. So now I want to construct a sunshade connecting these two with some circular thing I want. Click. Draw a line. So this is the sunshade I want. Click. You have to just draw one line only, not a closed entity. Okay, since I want curve type, I selected the curve and drawn this. So you already created a projected sunshade there. We'll go to 3D. You can see that he created that inside. When you click this, you can see one arrow here. You can bring little up here. How much you want, you can bring it here. You can use this, or because you don't want there. You can see that. Okay, so let us bring this is out little more. You can adjust this. So you can see now. Sunshade. So that is any design you want, you can create using the roof by extrusion. I hope you could understand this. Okay. Now let us move on to the next command, which is, so we have finished roof by footprint, by extrusion. And in the roof, if you want to have a fascia, suppose you want fascia here, I'll keep this to hidden view. I want to have a fascia here. So I will use roof, fascia, and click this corner, click. So we created a fascia. That means it's vertical projection, okay? You can see from here, you can see there is a small vertical projection in the roof, fascia. Suppose you want to have a gutter here. You can create using roof gutter and select the edge, click. So you can see that he has created one gutter. He has created a gutter. Okay, and sometime you want some design in the wall here. For example, you want some cutting in the wall here. So what you can do is, there is a wall, sweep and reveal. Reveal mean it goes inside, cutting like this. Sweep mean it is projecting outside. Projecting some. Sometime in the wall you want to make some projections, you can use the wall sweep and wall reveal. Wall sweep, you can see this is a projection. It takes little time. So it came. So it is a projection. So that's a small projection came. It's a projected one. So you can have this projection using the wall sweep. Okay, even you can have vertical. When you select the wall sweep, either you can have horizontal or vertical. Suppose you want a vertical projection. Click here. It takes little memory. That is why it's taking little time. Okay, once you finish this modify, you can see that has come. So, okay, so these are projection. Suppose you want to make cutting reveal. Suppose you want to make horizontal cutting here. Click. So it goes the cutting inside. This is gone inside the cutting. This is a cutting and this is projection. This projection, this is bent inside. You can try this. Okay, so this you can use it for that. Sweep and reveal. Now let us move on to, I hope up to here it is over the staircase now. I'll go to floor level 1. I'm going to create a staircase here. So architecture, stair. Stair can be done by two methods. One is by component and stair by sketch. So let's see how you create using component. So when you click stair by component, click that one. You are in the sketch mode. Okay. So first of all, you have to check from which floor to which floor. So you are going to construct the staircase from level 1, which is ground, to level 2, to the roof. And the height between these two is 400. Okay. So there is a default here. Staircase 180 is the maximum rise and 275 is the maximum thread. So as per this calculation, it requires 23 steps. 23 steps are required. 23 rises are required. Okay. And the thread height, thread is 275. Desired number 23. I can make it to 24. I want. I'll make it to 24. In that case, the riser height is 166. Maximum riser height you can go is 180. I can't make reduce it. If I can make 20, then he will not ask. He will say error, because if 20 means the height is 200, riser height, but maximum allowable is 180. Okay, so I can go increase, not the decrease. So we are going to draw the staircase now from level 1 to level 2. The height is 400 and it requires 24 steps. And we are going to draw the stair using the first method. So run, and we are going to do the straight one. Okay. So I'm going to draw. So he's showing me 14 risers. Balance, I will click here, and little gap I will click again. Click again. Okay, so all the 24 over now. All the 24 over. Someone is drawing something. Don't disturb me. Okay. So we can see from 3D the staircase. We created the staircase. We show the first point here, second point here, and little gap I provide and click the third point and fourth point. So this became landing. Okay. Let us go back to level 1 again. I will delete this. We'll make again stair by component. I can click here, start here. When I make 12, I click here, click. Okay, then I will come this side and click again and click this side. Click. So I created a stair like this. Your stair is ready. Don't worry about this railing. Some problem is there, that way don't worry. And when you look, you can see that these stairs are created with the handrails. Some duplication has come. You can check from here, orbit. Okay, it's okay. You can see this handrail, it automatically creates the handrails. You can delete the handrail if you don't want. These are separate pieces. You can delete and you can recreate if you want. Go to railing, place on host, go nearby and click. So it created the automatically, it create the handrail. So the handrail is automatically created when you make the steps. You can change the pattern of this. You select. And there is another pattern. See here, railing is 900. You can change it to another one. So it is vertical now. Select this. Okay, so the different type of, you can change it. Suppose you want to make it to glass type. There is a glass panel type is here. You can see the glass panel type. Glass panel. So there are different patterns you can use to create the staircase. Okay, that's how you create the stair. Go to level one again. I'll delete this. When you create the stair by component, this is the one you have to select the run. Then whatever different models are there, this is straight line. That is why we made straight one. Okay, let's make one more straight one. So 23 rises now. Click. So I created a straight one. You can, and the pattern of the handrail you can change from here itself if you want. You see that there are different type of pattern which you have seen, 900 pipe, rectangular, this pipe. You can change it to that. Again, any model you want, you can change that and say okay. And you can see that the staircase is now this, it's from here to it is going up. You see now staircase is coming like this from here. You can, suppose you want to make it from here to here, click this. So it reverse. Now the staircase is coming from here to going up. Okay, so you can change that orientation how you want the staircase. And you can see when you go to 3D, you can see this handrails are on the steps. The handrails are on the steps. We can move it to here. Suppose I delete this. delete this, go to railing, place on host. You see, he's asking thread or stringer. Stringer means the handrail will be supported on this stringer, which is the edge coping. Otherwise, he will keep in the thread. So let us go to stringer. Click. Now you see that it is supported on the stringers. If you have stair, if you have only one side, and if you want to put the other side, you cannot use the railing with the host. It will not work. It will not select. If you want to draw one side, it is not possible. You have to delete the second one also. Delete that also. Now you try. So this is a very important thing here. From here you say thread or stringer, click. That's how you do the stair now. Okay. When you go to edit type, you can change many things from there. You can try. You can go to edit type and you can make many changes. Okay. Let us go to other type of stair. I will erase this. So go to level one, stair by component. So we have drawn so far straight one. This is the full step spiral. You show the first point and you show the second point. Click. You can see the 3D. So this is a spiral type stair. Level one, delete, go to other type, center and spiral. I will show you this again because we did not accept this. The spiral one, first point, second point, click, okay. Go to 3D. You can see the staircase. Okay. Go back. Let me select this. Delete, stair by component. I'll make another type, center and spiral. Center and you can see, click. Okay. We have another type of stair. Okay, there are different types, you can try that. Depend upon how much circle you show, that then only that pattern will differ depending upon the circle you are showing. So you can try that by component. We'll make this is a L type. This is U type. Click. So this is the type you made now, L type, No. Now we'll go to the stair. You type, click, okay. So this is what. Can view from different angle. Okay. So you can try this, and if any doubt, you can contact me. Now we'll go to the stair by sketch. So here, stair by component, it was very standard type of stair only you can do. Suppose you want little circular, some complicated type and something like that, you can use the stair by sketch. So let us see stair by sketch. So here basically you have to use the riser and the boundary. So let us make a riser first. So I will draw riser one line. Click. Another line. And here, whenever you make the stair, the height is very important. Now, if you want to learn this, then and level one to level two, if you draw, the steps you have to draw 21 steps you have to draw. So it will take a lot of time. So what we'll do is I'll make an extra level just to teach you. We'll make a small level, extra level we'll make. Go to architecture, go to south. So we'll make a small level here. Level, say about 600. Like this, and you can see 601 level. So this is just for to create the staircase only. Level 5. We can say, can't say stair steps. Okay. I will go back to level 1. So I will use the stair by sketch. I have to draw the riser, and the riser from level 1 to level 5 steps. Level 1 to level 5, small step if you want. So how many steps required? It require only 4 steps, 4 risers. I will draw the first riser. Second riser, and the third I will copy, select this, copy, multiple, okay. So I have drawn the steps, risers, 4 risers, so 0 remain. Now I have to draw a boundary for this. So I will use the boundary. Draw a line from here to here, here to here. So it's a very simple step. Just entrance, you want to small steps. So this is very easy. So you only have to be very careful which level to which level you want the steps. That is very important. So I have drawn this. Okay. My steps are ready. The steps are very ready. Like this, you can change the from this way. You can see now. Step 4 steps. four rises, 1, 2, 3, 4. And automatically it comes, and you, anytime you can change this to another model, you can change from here to anything. Anytime you can change. Okay. And all this also you can change by going edit type, and you can change the, so you can make it circular. Any type you can make. Okay. Now this is a plain one. Suppose I want to make a curved type. So what I have to do, for example, let me draw a stair by sketch, riser. Suppose I want a curved step. Okay. Offset this, then we'll make offset about 300. Good. So four steps we created. Now steps are over, rises are over. We have to create four rises. Now we have to draw the boundary. Boundary always should draw from first point to last point. First point to last point. So your staircase is ready. Okay. You can see the 3D. Circular. Even you can make, suppose we want another type of things. Suppose I want to edit this, edit. You can edit anytime. I will remove this. Remove this. I want to make a curve there. Curve. Curve. Okay. So now I have to extend this line to. I have to extend this line. So I will use the trim action command. Click this. Use a multiple. Okay, so this is the boundary, and these are the risers. It should be always like this. This riser should not go beyond, or even if it is not touching, also it will be a problem. It can't be like this. You cannot have, or we can't have inside also. Not like this. It should touch always. See that? Set this. So sketching is a very, very interesting, and you can do any model sketch up you, the staircase steps you can make. Stair by sketch. So anyone is small, some more things very remaining. Mm-hmm. I will quickly go through the railing, which is very easy. I'll just do railing. Okay, let's go to railing command. Rail by sketch and place on host. Place on host, I told you, if you don't have the railing anywhere, then you can use the railing with place on host. Suppose you don't have these two, you can use the railing and place on host. This is for sketching. Suppose you want to have handrail garden, you require some handrail which will not have any steps or anything. So how will you do that? So there you can use the railing by sketch. First you have to draw the sketch how you want it. Suppose I want a handrail like this. See that it was not connecting here because there is a, when you click the line here, you click this chain, should be on, then only it will become single piece. I'll delete this, again draw line. Okay, this chain should be on. 1, 2, 3, and make a small curve here. Click line. So you want to have, it need not be closed. If you want, you can close it even if it is not closed. So you want to have a handrail like this. It's a garden or something you want. Handrail, when you look from the plan, it should be like this. So I have drawn whatever pattern I want. No need not closing it. Okay, now after this, you have to select what type of this railing. From here, you can select what type of railing you want. That you can change later also. Okay. So it created a handrail. See here? It created the handrail. And you can change the pattern anytime from here. Rectangular. Here, there is another one is called glass bottom. So you can select whichever you want. Okay. And if you want to adjust the distance and number of things, then you have to go to edit. When you go to edit, you can see rail structure. This is for, click this. These are the horizontal lines here. You can increase or decrease. You can keep the distance also. You can adjust the distance. So this is for horizontal. This, the first one is for horizontal rail structure. That is for horizontal. The vertical, you have to click baluster placement. Click this. And here, this, by controlling this, you can increase. So this is for main bars. Main bars. And this is for end bar. And starting bar and end bar. This, you can adjust this values, space and other thing. You can try this. So that is for editing. So that's how you do the handrail. Okay, let me just finish the ramp also. It's very, also very simple. Architecture, ramp, level one. I want to construct a ramp from level one to level five step, that step. So I will draw ramp. The ramp is not enough, length should be more. Okay, just so what I did was I went to architecture, architecture, ramp. Okay, then I'm using the run. Okay, and I'll just show the first point. So it is going to draw a ramp from level one to level five. Click. Okay, so I have created a ramp here. Okay, so this is a ramp. You see here ramp, from it goes ramp. So from zero level to the height you are given 500, but a level step that. Okay, here also you can change this one. Okay, and this ramp, even when you select this one, you can change it to edit type. There are two type. One is, suppose usually your ramp will be starting from zero here and it goes to that height, no? So here you get, if you look from the you can see it is uniformly it is going. Okay. Level one. Okay. When you look from 3D, this you can select this and go to edit type. And from here you can see thick and solid. Suppose you make it to solid, your ramp becomes like this. From zero, it goes to that required height. That is, you have to change from here, solid or thick. See now? So these are the commands which I want to teach you today. So we have seen how to create a roof, flat roof, slope roof. Then we have gone through stair, different type of component by sketch. Then we have seen railing, we have seen ramp,